Hey everybody, this is Anders.
This is Jonas.
We're from Catatonia and you're watching Nerve TV. We have a kind of a tradition with our titles that they can mean more things than one. That's what's been going on most of the titles on the last couple of albums, you know. Viva Emptiness, The Great Cold Distance, there you go again, and now Night is the New Day. I mean, the whole title just reflects the way we look upon life. You know, where the world is going, basically, in the end. It's going down. We always have to be in a private and personal state of mind to create music with Catatonia. We are always struggling to find happiness. This is pretty much what we're doing. You know, that's the struggle of life. Finding the inspiration and also having some kind of hope for tomorrow, for the day after, you know. But the process to get there, to find happiness, it's pretty much a dark journey. That's what we're about. We write about that process. If we reach, you know, kind of certain state of happiness, maybe the reason to have Catatonia would be more decreased, you know. So I'm not saying that I'm happy to be depressive or anything like that. It's not like that, you know. The whole process of creating music and releasing albums is a delicate thing, especially for us, since we take it or we base it on such a personal foundation. You shouldn't go too far there or too far there, and it's just a delicate thing, you know. You want to keep your integrity, but also be a successful band and keep your label happy, basically, you know. Visions come in a sick room bed.
There's something left to learn. As you say, you know, releasing the album, we're giving it away, and it's not our baby anymore. It's grown up and it's about to move, you know, into adulthood or something.
It's a kidnapped baby.
It's a kidnapped baby, yeah. But also you can see it like if you have a baby, you have to give it a good upbringing. So when it's time to release it, it can live its own life, you know. And the same thing with albums. We work really, really hard on the albums so that they can have a life of their own. That's our mission.
There's nothing more rewarding for us than after we have completed a Catatonia album, go out on tour and see that we share the same feeling for the album with our own people, with the fans, you know. That's the highest reward we can ever have in it.
As far as lyrics go, I usually collect anything that I write because I always want to have a finished song before I finish off the lyric, because otherwise I have to maybe change the lyrics. If I'm very happy with the lyric and all of a sudden Anders tells me there's another verse coming in, you know, then the whole feeling is destroyed. So to complete the lyrics, I need the final songs. But of course I do write from time to time, just taking notes on whatever's on my mind, you know. Inspiration is always there, pretty much, because of certain happenings, different phases in life, stuff like that. And I think it's interesting to keep track on what is going on in my life. I can look back on older albums and I can see exactly what kind of person I was back then. But at the time I wrote those lyrics, I didn't have an idea, you know. That's That's the fun part of it. They're just expressing one opinion, and if we should listen to a lot of critics, then we would be we wouldn't have the band anymore. Otherwise, the music would be, you know, totally schizophrenic or something. I think our music is it's good in hard times, you know, when people have problems around them. It's a way out of your everyday struggle. You can do something different for a while. For us, it's about writing songs. For them, they can listen to our songs.
That's the cleansing process, I think, you know. You need to dig deep into the misery to get out of it, so to speak. For us, that's the way it works. As I said before, if I wouldn't have Catatonia, which is seen as a dark and depressive band, I would be even more depressive. That's the concept right here. The darkest one, I was nothing ever. Somewhere in the future, we might not now even know where we're gonna go next. But we definitely know it's gonna be dark again, you know. It helps us stay alive and find a meaning in life. Brand new sky.